From teenage heartthrob to global superstar, Robbie Williams has had a wild ride. He's one of the best-selling artists of all time, who's also had his dark days battling alcohol and drug addiction. But the 45-year-old says family's been his salvation, and now he has a special Christmas wish. He spoke with Nine correspondent Amelia Adams in London.
You've had an incredible ride.
What is life like now for Robbie Williams? Are you in a good place?
Yes, I am. I like me. Well, I don't love me, but I like me better. But I like my life a lot. Yeah.
Well, liking you is the most important thing.
For everybody.
Yeah.
To like me
no.
is the most important thing.
To like yourself.
But yes, it is.
He certainly had no shortage of fans. And this is where it all began. Whatever I said, whatever I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good. Want you back, want you back, want you back for good. 16-year-old Bobby Williams shot to fame in Take That, breaking records and stealing hearts, until in 1995 he decided to go solo.
He left Take That. Devastating teenage girls everywhere. Obviously turned out to be a fairly good decision.
Texit, as they called it. I was high on cocaine. I just thought I was the best thing ever and I needed to go and sell 80 million records. Of course, is what I went and did.
He's honest and open about the years of drug and alcohol abuse and his continuing struggle with mental health.
Is that something that you need to work on still every day?
Yeah. It doesn't go away, you know. I don't think you ever stop feeling odd. You just get used to it, I suppose. I'm all right as long as I stay away from drinking drugs. I see my life as like a bottle with the silt in the bottom. The silt will always be there. And if I pour alcohol or drugs into there, the bottle goes like that and everything becomes murky.
He's worth more than $200 million, has sold close to 80 million records, and has overtaken David Bowie's record for the most number one albums ever sold by a British solo artist. She won't forsake me. But it was meeting American actress and TV host Ada Field that truly changed his life.
What do I think is my greatest achievement? Monogamy. Mm. Yeah, that wasn't on the cards. Mm. Yeah. Quite. Oh, you know, and sobriety, I suppose. Because, you know, I could say my kids, but I did very little to achieve the kids. Ask Ida.
Married for 9 years, the couple has three children, 7-year-old Theodora or Teddy, 5-year-old Charlie and 1-year-old Coco.
I am strict dad, fun dad, silly dad, whimsical dad. It's like unfinished sentences. Mm. Would you? Oh, you know, that kind of happens all day. Leave him to.
And the things you find yourself saying as a parent that you never thought you'd have to say, like, don't do that to your sister, or...
Don't stick that carrot up his arse again.
Exactly.
I thought these strangers were going to come and ruin the party. Mm. And the opposite of that has happened. The universe leaves you these blanks that you don't know you need to fill, and you have to sort of, like, tick the box on the human experience, and you don't know that they're blanks until you experience everything. And when the children come, these blanks filled, and you look back and you go, oh wow, yeah, I'm in a different level. I've achieved level family.
He's fiercely protective of his clan, choosing to hide his children's faces on social media.
Name me one famous young person that's done really well mentally later on in life. Name me one. They don't exist. You know, like, fame is a illness, and I want to vaccinate them as long as I can.
Just last year, daughter Teddy made her public debut at the age of six with a starring role in the royal wedding of Princess Eugenie to Jack Brooksbank.
That was a decision that had to be made in close quarters. Like, yeah, we're protecting them, but also our friends are getting married that we love and adore, and they just so happen to be royal, and they've asked if Teddy can be one of the page girls. And, you know, it was kind of like, what do we do? But then our daughter got to be in the ceremony. It was so cool.
And also provided arguably one of the best moments of the day when she asked Fergie if she was the queen.
Yeah, yeah. She
classic.
Yeah, she asked Fergie if she was the queen. Yeah, I think her little friend told her that that was the queen.
Splitting their time between London and LA, it's an extravagant lifestyle. But the couple is determined to keep their kids as grounded as possible.
Mum's really cool. I'm really cool. We're really cool together. The house is full of laughter and full of joy. And if you're surrounded by love, then you will be love. And if you feel loved, then you're whole. That's what I've learned from going therapy.
And now he's sharing the love with an unexpected new challenge.
It's become my raison d'être to write a song that lasts forever and annoys everybody every year, once a year at least.
Yeah.
And name me the last Christmas hit. Can you name me the last Christmas hit?
Mariah Carey's not the last one, but it is. It is.
88 or something. 88 or 89. What does that say about people? They don't want them. Oh, I had to rethink this whole thing. Hanging up your
stockings on the wall. Several original numbers and the help of some guest stars, Robbie Williams' new goal is to do the unthinkable and knock the Queen of Christmas off her mistletoe perch.
It's been the odd one that's kind of raised a fist at it, but no one's pulled it off yet. So, well, since 88 anyway, or 89. So hopefully it will be me. I have the ammo. I know that I've got the songs. We'll see. It's my one Christmas wish for me to have the number one record and a number one Christmas album, do you think?
And you can catch Robbie in Not the Robbie Williams Christmas Show, which is straight after A Current Affair tonight.